Hi Makenj, I'm Thashmini and I'm in my third year of civil engineering and co-op at McMaster. So today I'll be taking you along with me for my day. Hi guys, so I'm about to go into my presentation, which is about an hour long. Kind of nervous, but I'm also excited. We'll see how it goes.
I'm back. So I just finished my presentation and it was good. And now I'm just gonna get started on some work. And then I'll be going in person to check on some lab data. Hey everyone, I'm back. I'm actually heading towards campus now. I had a soil lab that I did last week, and we are currently collecting data for it every single day. So one of our group members goes each day, and today that's me. So I'm gonna take you along with me to JHE, which is the John Hodgins Engineering Building, and you'll get to see what I'm doing there. See you there. I'm currently at Thode. It's actually one of my favorite places to study. It gets packed a lot, so it can tend to get loud, but I like to find a little spot in the back corner and do my lectures and things like that. But if I'm really studying hardcore for an exam, you can usually find me at my house in my room. So I don't think I got a chance to mention this, but Thode is actually the engineering library. And while it is the engineering library, you can find students from all programs using it because it's one of the biggest and it's Hey guys, so it's a couple of hours later now and I just finished a couple of lectures and tutorials and now I'm on to do some more homework for the night. I just wanted to come here and sign off on this vlog for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you like coming along with me, because I sure did. And see you very soon. Bye!
Hey, MacEng YouTube. My name's Hunter. I'm in my fifth year of mechatronics engineering and society. And today, I'm going to be doing my day in the life tour. So I'm actually on co-op this year, so I don't have a full slate of classes. However, as part of the Engineering Society program, I am doing a minor in psychology, and I'm doing a class this semester that counts towards that minor. So I figured I'd take you just to see the tutorial that I'm about to do, and then I will bring you to where I hang out to listen to the lecture afterwards. So I'm gonna mask on, and I'll see you in ABB. Okay, so I'm over at ABB now, or the AN Borns building.
Officially a science building.
Walk in here. But I've had plenty of classes here. But you get these cool little science displays all scattered around the building, like this physical version of the periodic table here. So I'll show you them as I walk in my class. My class is right down the hall here, so I will see you afterwards.
So I just finished my tutorial. Today we actually talked about something that was really relevant to engineering, about how companies like Toyota can influence your habits in order to make you more incentivized to purchase like electric vehicles, which is a really cool thing, and is one of the reasons I love learning about psychology and how it relates to engineering. So I'm walking over to Hatch to watch my lecture. I go in the tunnels like this, between ABB and JHE, which is right down there. Unfortunately, it is locked, but there's tunnels like this all over campus, and you'll find out that more often than not, the buildings are connected through indoor passageways, which is really nice during the winter. So I'll see you in Hatch. So I decided to take a quick detour to the third floor of the John Hodgins Engineering Building to show you my personal favorite room on campus, the Society Lounge. It's for engineering and society students, as well as engineering management students, but in my experience, it's been mostly used by engineering and society students. Unfortunately, it's closed, so you can't really see anything. You can trust me when I say it's one of like the nicest places to study on campus if you're in engineering society or engineering management, because it's so tucked away, not a lot of people know about it. And now I realize as I'm saying this that everyone's going to know about it now, so I guess I have to live with my own mistake. Yeah, I've made a lot of memories here, so it's a great place. My favorite place on campus. But I will be studying downstairs in Hatch. You can see a bird's eye view of Hatch right here. This is the junction. It's where people can study, and you can socialize on the couches there. There's also a bunch of Hatch rooms, private Hatch rooms that you can rent out, which is what I'll be doing in a few moments. And there's project lockers down there where you can rent to store your projects in. So it's a great place built by students for students. So yeah, let's go. Hey, I'm back. I managed to get one of the larger Hatch rooms here, Hatch 204B. And I'm about to go watch my lecture. But before that, I'll just show you a little bit around the room. There's a whiteboard, projector that you can roll down here. There's another portion of the room on the other side, so this room can open up and be a large conference room. And you can see into Hatch Bay right here. You can see people working on different club projects like Baja or McMaster Mars Rover, stuff like that from time to time. So personally, I use the Hatch space a lot to just have a private room to study or to work on assignments or anything like that. And more recently, I've been using it after my tutorial to watch my lectures. So I'm gonna get to that right now and I'll see you in about 2 hours. Okay, after 2 hours approximately, I'm back in my car. I'm about to head home. So I hope you enjoyed following me around today. I know my day didn't include a lot of engineering, but I hope you learned a little bit about how we get a chance to learn here about how engineers are affected by other things in society other than just our technical learning, such as human behavior. So if you liked the video, make sure to like and subscribe to MacEng. And if you have any questions about anything that happened in this video, any of the buildings that I visited, or anything about MacEng in general, feel free to comment down below, and I'll be there to try to answer them, as well as I'm sure a bunch of other student ambassadors from Mac. So until next time, thanks everyone.